Hello everyone. In today's session, we will cover a very important topic, which is basically alerts or notifications. And that is very important when you talk about any of the ERP system. In Dynamics GP and Great Plains, there were business alerts. Here there are alerts, event-based alerts. And these are very important because for example, when a new vendor or a customer is inserted, the new record has been inserted. So you need to get notified, or concerned person need to be notified about that one, that a vendor or a new customer has been created. Similarly, for example, a due date on the basis of any document like a purchase order or invoice is entered, and you need to basically check whether the due date has passed or is reaching in within few days. So you need to notify the concerned or relevant person about that, or he himself need to be he or she need to be notified about the due date or any of the other date on the basis of which you need to be notified. So this will be basically available in action centers or through emails. So in the action center, you can see here whatever alerts are that is basically also need to be enabled on the user options. If you go to the user options, and within the user options, you can see here send notification in email, send notification to action center, and this need to be about workflow, but these need to be enabled per user. And then another option is very important, and that is basically if you go to the system admin, in the system admin, in the email processing, not in the email processing, just collapse it, go to the setup, and within the setup you find an email group, and in email parameter you basically need to configure the email parameters. That is a setting for SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, or any of the other email provider ID. You need to be setting it up before you can use the email notifications. So here I have configured SMTP, and in the SMTP settings, basically various settings are defined based on Microsoft.com domain, and password and all the settings are defined, like SSL and TLS is turned on, and then outgoing mail server address is given, SMTP port number is given, authentication required is ticked, and then password is entered, and you just need to test the connection, which need to be successful in this case. And same way, then you need to also test the email by choosing the setup provider ID, and send to your own email address, whatever it is, and then send the test email, which need to be basically receiving at your end. So that setup need to be done before you can go ahead with the alert settings. And for the alert setting, you can go to the any of the page, like if I go to the purchase order, so you can see it at the action pane of app options. Within the options, you can see the group of share. Within the share group, you can find create a custom alerts or manage my alerts, which are basically for existing alerts. Once you have defined an alert, so you can go and change any of the setting within manage my alerts. But if you want to define a new alert, you can go ahead with create a custom alert here. So I will just pick up any of the open order here, and just let me open it and check the delivery date, which is 25th of September 2022, which is today's date. And here if I go to the options, although it was available also on the list page, but I needed to check whether about this delivery date, I need to put an alert on this one. So I will create a custom alert here. Just click on the create a custom alert, and it will show you the options, which will just appear, and I will show you. On the right hand side, you can see the table name is already picked as a purchase order, and purchase table additional field and addresses are also there. whatever the tables or data sources behind this form are also given. Initially, it is for all the fields, so it means a record has been created or deleted. So, on the basis of creation or deletion of the record, you need to basically alert yourself. Here, the alert me for is option is giving you the option for current record or for all records. So, if all records are selected, so then record whenever it is created on the purchase order table. So, basically, then you need to email yourself basically or alert yourself by a subject and a message. And then you need to basically define whether you want to send an email to you yourself, like, and then email recipients need to be defined here. So, or you can select a different user as well. For here, I will not choose this because this is a very general error, but I will show you by selecting, for example, the delivery date. So, this is the delivery date. Once you select delivery date, you can see in the events, more events have been added. So, record has been created and deleted, where earlier on only two events, but now it is showing you more options, which are basically comparison with the date when a delivery date has been postponed or has been postponed until certain date has changed or is due in. So, I will, is due in is basically if you want to get an alert before a certain days before the delivery date has reached. For example, 7 days before the delivery date is basically reaching. So, you need to just define, 7 days, when delivery date is due in 7 days, then you will get the alert and on the basis of the current record, only I need to be notified. Current record means the purchase order number 37. I need to be notified only when there are 7 days left for the due date. But since the due date is, the delivery date is today's date, so the 7 days already passed. So, I need to just change it to, for example, has changed. Whenever delivery date has changed, so alert me on the basis of the current record. Okay. So, alert me until. So, this looks like when you set the batch options, similarly, no end date or end date. So, I will just select no end date. Or if I select an end date, so means when the end date is reached, so it will stop alerting me, sending me alerts. So, apart from I can select no end date means always it will need to send me the alerts without any date. So, then, okay, so this is a subject which is a generic subject. So, if I need to put a purchase order number, that is also possible here. Field delivery date in table purchase order has changed. So, I can put here, for example, purchase order number, and same message I will need to be putting here in the message body, and I will select send email, and email recipient is myself. So, if there is another domain name, so you can select here send externally. Otherwise, you will just pick the existing, email recipient, which is my current user. So, on that user, this email is set. So, now we are good to go. And this is the only setup which is required when a delivery date is being changed. So, I will click OK and the alert is set. Now, there need to also check. There are two things which need to be set up, which are basically batch job. And I will show you, if you go to the system administration module and if you collapse everything and go to the periodic task, go to the alerts, you can see there are two kind of periodic task or batch jobs basically. One is change based alerts and the other one is due date alerts. So, what is difference between these two? Basically, the change based alerts, as you have seen when I was defining the alert earlier, for all fields, there were two events. One was for creation of record, the other one was for deletion of record. So, that is or any of the other field, then a date field, will be basically trigger using this change base alerts. But if you select due date alerts, so this will be basically based upon whatever the date base alerts you are defining. So this will target the due date alert. So I will just select this. Basically, before the selection, let me also show you the batch screen, batch job screen. And before that, you also need to be running the batch service. So there are quite a setup about this. So this batch management service need to be running, otherwise the batch job will not run. And also the batch server need to be assigned, batch group and server. So if you go to the system administration and then go to the inquiries and batch jobs, you need to select here alerts. You can see change based alerts is already set up by some other user and it is withheld. So I need to basically change the status of this withheld to the waiting state. Okay, and apart from this, I need to also check recurrence. Basically, it needed to be checked earlier when it was on withheld state. But anyhow, I will change it to my time. No end date and minute. Every minute it is running basically. So I will put it today's date. Okay, and the time to start is earlier. Okay, that's good. So it will be running every minute. And the other job is, I have not found it here. So I need to basically configure the other job. This is change based alert. And so I need to select this due date alert in order to set up the batch job. Okay, I will select the batch processing here. Recurrence again, I will make it 1 minute already, no end date. And for each minute, in order to test this functionality, okay, and I will just batch group, empty batch group I have already selected here, and just select okay. Okay, so now if you refresh this, so you can find there are two alerts. Basically, one is in executing, the other one is in a waiting state. So now what I will do is basically change the delivery date in order to trigger the event. And before that, I will also show you manage my alerts. Within manage my alerts, if I can show you here, field delivery date in table purchase order. This is our alert, which we have just created, and this need to be triggered when the delivery date has been changed. So I will just go ahead and change the delivery date by editing the PO. And make it, for example, 27th of September, and just save it, update delivery date, and click OK. Okay, so once it is changed, basically I need to confirm it, but it does not need a confirmation. And once you have already changed the delivery date, it will trigger the event. So the PO has also been confirmed. So I have deleted change based alert batch job and I am reconfiguring it. And this need to be basically set up because this will be handled by change based alert of delivery date change. So I will select 1 minute here and no end date. Click OK. Batch group will be empty. And just click OK. So it is in batch queue. I will just need to check the batch inquiry, batch job inquiry, and filter it on alerts. Okay, so this is change based alert and it is in executing. Just let it complete, and it has completed and started running. And meanwhile, I will check my mail here, and you can see it has shown me change based alert field delivery date in table purchase order has changed. field delivery date in table purchase order has changed, and it is basically informing me to go to the purchase order form where the field has basically changed. So this one is the purchase order, which has been basically the delivery has changed here, and this has correctly alerted me through change base alert. But whatever the fields or all fields or the record has been created or deleted need to go through change base alert. If there is a due date base, like due date in certain time or certain days, or due date is just reached, so that will be handled by due date base badge job. So this is a very useful option, and I hope that most of the users and users, they need themselves to be reminded whenever a new record is created or a record has been deleted, or a certain due date as a reminder. You want to keep track, just like you keep track in Outlook for a specific email as a reminder that you need to act on that email. Similarly, on various documents within D365, you also need to enable yourself to remind you whenever something has changed, some field value has changed, or due date has is about to be reached. So in that case, this is very useful feature available on options form through manage my alerts for existing and create a custom alert for new one. So for example, if you go to account receivable and go to the customers form, so for every of the form or page, you will find the this custom alerts within the options, and there you will find it. So this is how you can basically keep track of changes within the system. I think this will be a very useful feature, and please let me know about any of the comment on this. Thank you very much, guys. Take care. Bye bye.